James von Prague, a man who floated around the film industry in the background, couldn't quite get himself inserted into a role, doing odd jobs, trying to get into the business. It's said that he had a fixation with death, that he focused on it heavily. As a result, he focused on these paranormalist and psychic ideas, which are now the staple of his career. He's since claimed about his early life that when he prayed to God for divine revelation, he witnessed a radiant hand extending itself through the ceiling, which he believed to be the hand of God. He intended to make a career in Hollywood, and he moved to Los Angeles to start that career. However, to make money in the meanwhile, before he took off in terms of his television career, he started doing psychic readings. He claims that it was to bring messages from the dead, to bring peace and reassurance to the living, when in actuality, it was more to do with him making a living until he could insert himself into a suitable showbiz role. But over time, mixing the idea of the Hollywood scene as well as psychic phenomena, he was able to build up, from practically nothing, a notable career. His early television career was mostly focused on appearing on daytime television, including the NBC paranormal talk show, The Other Side, and from there he was able to gain more television time, slowly but surely becoming a more recognized personality, talking about life after death, and the ability to communicate with the dead. He has appeared on many shows over the years, including The Oprah Winfrey Show, Larry King Live, Dr. Phil, as well as Nightline, Unsolved Mysteries, and The View. He's had a strong career in the theatre, in terms of stage work, and doing performances across the United States and beyond. He's also sold a multitude of books over the years about his favourite subject, the afterlife. And he really gained the notoriety that he desired when it came to him being co-executive producer of the CBS show The Ghost Whisperer. He has been caught out on several occasions where his so-called evidence has not been up to scratch. When people have spoken about his performances, they've stated how poor some of the evidence actually is. In several live performances on daytime television, he seems to offer nothing of any real substance. However, a great many other people claim that he offers very good information. As with most TV psychics, the stuff you see on TV, when it's not live, is heavily edited. A long reading that goes on for 10, maybe 15 minutes, will basically be whittled down to a matter of perhaps 30 seconds, perhaps 2 minutes, and only the best hits will be kept in for presentation.